will Spectrum react differently after Lee Fei's speech? Our Sharon Tan covers that aspect.
In a speech delivered this morning, top Beijing official Li Fei noted that Hong Kong should legislate on Article 23 of the Basic Law. Chief Secretary for Administration Matthew Cheung said that the government would act accordingly at the right time. He said that the government will not avoid the problem, but it must first create an appropriate atmosphere in the society for the legislation to move forward. As for Chief Executive Carrie Lam, she noted that it is heartbreaking to see a small group of people in Hong Kong trying to reject the idea of one country in recent years and placing two systems in opposition. LegCo members on the different ends of the political spectrum reacted differently.
Hong Kong should treasure the opportunity to enact the laws in relation to state security on our own.
If no say.
哎呀，唔好意思啊，遲咗收工，你小朋友仔啊，
唔緊要，係你媽咪同我買嘅廚具嚟㗎。媽咪，我今日去咗個新企業叫輪車啊。
Schools also watched the broadcast of Lee's speech this morning. The reactions towards the speech were much less intense. A secondary 5 student said that because Lee was speaking in Putonghua, students might not be able to catch everything. As for Sha Tin Chung Chin Secondary School, it decided not to broadcast Lee's speech. The school's principal, Chang Man Wai, believes that one-way public speaking is not a mainstream teaching method. The school added that they would trim and edit the tape featuring Lee's speech for the students to watch and enhance students' knowledge on the basic law through class discussion. Sharon Tang, TVB News.
A U.S. congressional report has concluded Beijing's policies towards Hong Kong are undermining the SAR's autonomy. The report called on U.S. lawmakers to examine options to impose penalties on Beijing for not abiding by its commitments to the SAR to increase.
Let's give her our support. Let's encourage her to quit smoking.
If you're willing to share. It's a beautiful thing to share life by giving blood. One blood donation can save 3 or more lives. Share life, give blood. You can do it.
Everyone can choose their pathway, straight or curved. There's no need to follow others. Make your own choice.
Vocational and professional education and
banks, which control nearly a third of Hong Kong's MPF market, are cutting their management fees from December 1st, benefiting some 1.5 million customers. As Anne-Marie Sim reports, the move is expected to be followed by other trustees in the city's compulsory pension scheme.
The city's largest bank, HSBC, announced today that the fee for some constituent funds will be slashed by 27%. Its subsidiary, Hang Seng Bank, is also reducing fees for selected funds. HSBC Hong Kong's head of pensions, Alfred Yip, noted that this was the sixth time since 2007 that it had reduced the management fees of selected constituent funds, benefiting 1.5 million accounts. HSBC manages $100 billion in pension assets. It has 2 schemes with 25 funds and will lower the management fees of 10 constituent funds. The reductions will range from 4% to a maximum of 27%. Their move could lead to more savings for the city's workforce, as other trustees are expected to follow suit in the wake of the default investment strategy, which caps fees at 0.75%. The city's compulsory pension scheme covers 2.8 million workers. The average MPF management charge stood at 1.55% at the end of last month. Anne-Marie Sim, TVB News.
Zimbabwe President Robert Mugabe remains in custody a day after the military took control of the country. Now citizens are waiting to see what steps the army will take in a potentially new chapter for the country. Tony Sabine reports.
While it appears the end of the road for President Robert Mugabe, for many Zimbabweans, life goes on as normal. Still, despite the calm on the streets of Harare, there is also unease at what happens next in Zimbabwe. Right now, Mugabe has been placed under house arrest for his protection after the army staged an apparent coup to get rid of what it called criminals within the ranks of government. Officials from the ruling ZANU-PF party were keen to point out that Mugabe is still president.
They had no problem with their commander-in-chief, which is the president. They had a problem with people that are some people that were around him, that were doing the purging, you know, that were doing the stealing. So the army was basically saying, we're going to clean this, we're going to open avenues for investment, and then we're going to walk out, and the civilians will carry on. But the president is still the president.
While denying they were taking over the country, the general seemed determined to stop Mugabe's wife, Grace, 41 years his junior, from succeeding the 93-year-old president who has ruled the country since formal independence in 1980. Grace has reportedly fled the country. Mugabe plunged Zimbabwe into a fresh political crisis last week when he fired his vice president and presumed successor, Emmerson Mnangagwa, for showing traits of disloyalty. The generals believe that move was aimed at clearing a path for Grace Mugabe to take over, and said on Monday they were prepared to step in if purges of their allies did not end. The international community has appealed for calm and no bloodshed.
The Secretary General has been monitoring the evolving situation in Zimbabwe. He appeals for calm, non-violence, and restraint. Preservation of fundamental rights, including freedom of speech and assembly, is of vital importance.
Mugabe, still seen by many Africans as a liberation hero, is reviled in the West as a despot whose disastrous handling of the economy and willingness to resort to violence to maintain power destroyed one of Africa's most promising states. Tony Savoy, TVB News.
The death toll has risen to 6 in California after a madman attacked 7 locations in a shooting rampage that included an elementary school. Sonia Artero reports.
Upon searching the home of the gunman, police discovered his wife dead inside. The suspect is identified as 44-year-old Kevin Neal. Investigators say he murdered his wife and hid her body by stuffing it under the floorboards of their home. Then he killed 2 of his neighbors.
In January of this year, he was arrested and charged with an assault with a deadly weapon on that person. That person is a deceased victim today.
All this happened one day before Neal carried out his shooting spree on Tuesday. That's when he opened fire at least 7 different locations.
Something happened because the soldier, bah, 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 so many times, bah, bah. I could look at the visual again, bah, 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 bah.
Then the assailant gunned down a mother escorting her child to school.
She was transporting, I believe, her children to school, driving down the road, passed by the vehicle, and he opened fire on them without provocation or warning.
Including his wife, he reportedly killed 6 people and wounded 10 others. During his rampage, the gunman drove to Rancho Tahoma Elementary School, where he rammed down their locked gate and began shooting into classrooms with a semi-automatic rifle. Staff at the school of 100 students are being hailed as heroes for their quick reaction after hearing gunshots nearby.
8 to 10 seconds had elapsed between the doors being closed for the lockdown and him appearing in the quad. At that time, he could be clearly seen in the surveillance video, shooting windows, shooting walls, and shooting doors.
1 6-year-old child was shot in the chest and foot, but is said to be in stable condition. The shooter at no time gained access to the classroom through doors or windows. The rampage ended when police rammed the vehicle Neal was driving and killed him in a shootout. Sonia Artero, TVB News.
Back locally, a German weapons manufacturer has decided to stop supplying spare parts for a submachine gun to the Hong Kong police force. Local police have been using the gun for the past 4 decades.
When Pakistani Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif visited Hong Kong in May, the city's police force were on high alert. Officers carrying the German-designed MP5 submachine gun could be seen everywhere around the hotel he was staying at. The local police force currently has 780 MP5s made by the manufacturer Heckler & Koch. But when the Hong Kong police attempted to purchase some MP5 parts early this year, the company declined to offer them. What's more, it told the force that Hong Kong has been removed from the company's list of places that it's allowed to sell firearms to. TVB inquiries to Heckler & Koch were left unanswered. We also approached the consulate of Germany here in Hong Kong, which consulted Berlin on the matter. In its reply, the consulate said the German government does not provide information on its firearm supplying decisions, and it will not comment on the choices of individual companies. Meanwhile, the local police force says the reason is because Hong Kong is not a member of NATO. The MP5 submachine gun was first introduced to the Hong Kong force in the late 70s. It's mostly used by the Airport Security Unit, the Special Duties Unit, and the VIP Protection Unit. Lawmaker James Toh says the force has been using and training with the MP5 for decades and is worried about the time it will take for police to find, purchase, and train with new equipment. Secretary for Security John Lee assured police force sources its firearms from multiple companies, and the department is not affected because of this.
The Hong Kong government announced today it is relaxing the rules regarding the contracts of foreign domestic helpers. Under the new arrangement, contracts that expire before the end of the year can be extended until the end of February next year. This is subject to the agreement of both the employer and the worker. The measure is in response to the Philippine government's decision to temporarily suspend issuing overseas employment certificates to Filipinos who want to work abroad. In sports, tens of thousands of football fans celebrated in Peru after their team became the last to qualify for next year's World Cup. More from Jeff Tang.
Just as Peru's president had promised, the country will have its football-dedicated holiday today. That's after the South American nation beat New Zealand 2-0 to win a two-leg playoff. That earned Peru the 32nd and final spot in the World Cup draw in Russia. The last time they reached the tournament was in 1982. After a goalless draw in New Zealand on Saturday, the Peruvians got the job done at home despite the suspension of their main striker Paulo Guerrero on doping suspicions. The Kiwis are unable to join their neighbours Australia at the football showcase next year. Last night, the Aussies qualified for the fourth straight time in front of 77,000 home fans in Sydney. This came after a superb hat-trick from skipper Mile Jedinak helped the Socceroos beat Honduras 3-1 on aggregate. Meanwhile, Italy sacked head coach Gian Piero Ventura 2 days after the Azzurri failed to qualify for the World Cup for the first time in 60 years. The four-time world champions had lost the European zone playoff to Sweden 1-0 on aggregate. Jeff Tang, TVB News.
According to the DIS.
We go, it will be mainly fine during the day tomorrow with a maximum temperature of around 27 degrees. That's the news for now. For watching, good night. We'll be right back.